The Owl House is returning this Saturday, that's July 11th, with new episodes here in America, and we got a new promo that gives us some amazing looks at what is to come. We've got witches sports, loose shrinking, and a surprise visit from the human world. We're gonna break it all down, but first, I just want to talk about the sponsor of today's video, Loot Crate, the subscription service that gives you a monthly haul of cool nerd stuff from your favorite fandoms. You can get the Basic Box, Rick and Morty, Marvel, or any of the others they have. I chose the Horror Box and got some really cool stuff. My favorite was the Lovecraft tote bag they sent me. We'll leave a link down below. Just use the coupon code CARTOONUNIVERSE15 for 15% off. And now, on to the video. The most important thing in this trailer, way at the end, is Luce's mother seemingly making it to the Boiling Isles. It's not just Luce seeing her through the door, she's clearly standing on some cobblestone. I personally think she will be brought in for the finale, where we learn that it's the end of summer in the human world, and now Luce is going to have to convince her mother that she belongs on the Boiling Isles, that it's a viable direction for her life to go. Now, one thing you guys probably notice is there's a whole lot of Lilith in this trailer, and she seems to be interacting with the Emperor himself in some of these shots. He's a crazy, regal-looking figure with a giant room and even a fancy throne he sits in, and Lilith appears to bow before him at some point as well. He is talking to Lilith, the leader of his coven, after him I presume, but something tells me this isn't a happy talk. We see another flash of the demon lady that Lilith answers to, and if I had to guess, the fact that she hasn't brought in Ida by the end of the season is something that she is going to be punished for, so she has to make a serious decision about arresting her sister. She's had a lot of opportunities, but clearly hasn't taken them. In seemingly the same location, we see Lilith casting a really big spell, something I think hints at her maybe turning against her own coven and trying to escape so she can help Ida, though it might actually be used against the kids. In a really quick flash, we also see Lu seemingly in the Emperor's palace as well, with Lilith holding her staff out threateningly. I think Luce may have overheard something, and Lilith is threatening to do some magic on her if she tries to warn Ida. I'm not sure why Luce would be there, but in another shot we see that both Gus and Willow seem to be there too, and Willow's plant magic might give them a way to break out and get to Ida safely. It would appear that the children had to sneak into the Emperor's palace for some reason, as this shot shows similar colors, and we see Luce using a new spell to get into some sort of triangular small passageway like an air vent. Lilith at some point will also be making a visit to the Owl House, but it doesn't seem like she is there doing some direct attack, as Hootie's just being his annoying self around her. I think this will be one of two things, her coming to Ida, asking her to turn herself in slash warning her of the Emperor's upcoming plan, and the other being that it's a lead-in to a mission they have together. Throughout the trailer, the two are seen running around in the woods together in their capes, seemingly chasing down a monster. They can be seen using magic, with Ida using fireballs and a cool ice sword thing. A lot of these shots involve statues in the background that may also double as gravestones. Perhaps the two are working together because it involves their family history. Some monster seems to be involved, like I said, and I think this is him from the other side. He's pretty spooky looking. Most exciting of all of this Lilith stuff is Luce attacking her. We see some new spells in this promo, as well as interesting uses of spells like attaching glyphs on paper to things like a mace, but here we see her slapping two papers together to create some sort of light or lightning attack. In this shot, she seems to be rescuing King from Lilith, but I think it may be a misunderstanding. While at first she is holding King, I think she was just talking to him almost casually, and Luce assumed he was in danger. Lilith's response seems less intense, more like she's afraid of hurting Luce and didn't expect her to be there at all because of a misunderstanding, instead of her planning to KO King as part of some ransom. What appears to be the same scene, we see her slamming a few more glyphs into the ground though, so it's anyone's guess what is going on here, but Luce seems to mean business. At the beginning of the promo, we see Luce in a yellow school uniform, which indicates that she is on the potion track. Don't get too excited though, because in previous promos we've seen what appears to be her in other track colors. In fact, later in the promo we see her wearing four different colors on her school uniform at the same time. I think the rest of the season will actually focus heavily on her trying all the different tracks to see which one is for her, only to realize that none of them are for her because she wants to be like Ida and learn all of the magic, something Hexside likely won't allow. Spaced throughout the promo are a lot of shots of what appears to be a popular sport on the Boiling Isles, one with a demonic-looking ball that can catch fire thanks to a new spell that Luce has. While it appears to be either a sort of gym class or extracurricular at Hexside, we also see Ida and Lilith playing against each other, a fun twist on their ongoing rivalry without it being just another battle like at the convention, even though that was pretty freaking cool. In these shots, Ida is wearing a varsity jacket, which implies that she actually played on the team back in high school. Perhaps it was the one thing she got involved in at the school that she really liked, and maybe it was the one thing she was able to beat her sister in, though it looks like Lilith might have the upper hand here. In the first half of the season, it felt like a rarity to see Amity, but towards the end, it became clear that her and Luce's friendship will be a central focus of the show, and there seems to be a lot of her in these upcoming episodes. One particularly cryptic shot shows Amity as a child with her parents talking as if they are disappointed in her. What's strange is that her hair is a different color here. Was it because of magic? Did she dye it when she got older to match the rest of their family? It makes sense, considering the roots of her hair in the front are close to the original orange in the shot. Amity appears again in this scene where she simply sighs in front of the lockers that Luce is somehow able to come out of in this odd way. We see even more of her and Luce in these really weird outfits. A lot of shippers took these outfits to be for some sort of school dance, but the way Amity outfits look gives me the feeling that it's some school play instead. Earlier in the promo, we can see them looking at other strange costumes as well, ones you definitely wouldn't wear to a school dance. I think the tuxedo tutu is cool, but a bit too over the top even for someone like Luce to wear to a dance. In that same outfit, we can see Luce slamming a mace down on the ground in some dungeon-looking place though, and it seems to have an ice spell attached to it, so I really don't know what is going on here and could be wrong, though this doesn't seem like a school dance either. In an earlier video, we talked about how the Russian website Kinopoisk claimed that an upcoming episode would be called Mini Problems, and this promo seems to indicate that that might be true. Throughout the promo, we see several shots of Luce, Gus, and Willow running around, but they're extremely tiny. The plot of this episode seems to feature the kids running around a carnival with King, and Grim Hammer turning the kids small to use them as some sort of carnival attraction. You can see when they're small that they get trapped in this glass box from Grim Hammer, who is also seen here in front of a sign that says Carnival. And when they seemingly escape, they have to ride a fly away from a giant cotton candy, which seems to connect all these different shots together in one episode. In that same episode, King looks kind of sad, as if he isn't fitting in well with Luce's witch friends and feels left out. In an entirely different promo, we get a sneak peek of what this Saturday's episode is actually going to be about, which seems to just be about Luce and King entering a writing contest together. We're introduced to a new character who is some sort of author of some young adult fiction series on the Boiling Isles, and I imagine it's some sort of plot that's going to leave Luce very disillusioned with the idea of writing, a parallel to how she's becoming disillusioned with the idea of magic in many ways, and realizing it's not as fun or simple or heroic as she thought. Back in the original promo, there are a few other shots I can't quite find any hidden details for, of course, but they're still very interesting. Here we have Willow doing some plant magic in the woods again, but no sign of anyone else or even something dangerous coming after her. Here we have Willow again gesturing towards something, followed by some shots of the covens again, likely explaining that Luce is going to have to choose a magic track while at school. Later we have King just entering some tavern of some sorts, maybe in the carnival episode, hoping to get people to help him save the kids, Willow sleeping on the couch, and Gus doing some light magic. Amity's siblings making it to the Owl House and doing some combined spell with smug smiles on their face, which is really sketchy. I hope they aren't doing anything evil, I like them acting nice in the recent episodes. This monster appears twice, first making children sleep, and then eating an abomination, seemingly all at Hexside. Ida turns Luce into a human horror-themed attraction at what appears to be the carnival. King writes the word blood with a smiley face. Luce says she loves everyone at the Owl House before leaving. Sleepy Willow is waving here. A mysterious student in gray appears in this hood. And finally, a giant crab having a hold of Lilith. I'm not certain what all of these mean, but if you have any ideas, leave a comment down below and we'll see what happens when the episode comes out. Subscribe to the channel so you can see all of our Owl House and other cartoon updates. We'll be making videos each week. Don't forget to check out Loot Crate and use our coupon code CartoonUniverse15, and I'll see you next time.